Are you? You ready? I'm gonna ask everybody. Yeah, come on. That was like, man. Fair enough. Okay, you guys ready for Bo Aitha? I think you are. Give it up for Bo Aitha.
Alrighty, guys. I always had the same dentist my entire life. He worked in the same shopping center as my dad. So they knew each other, and I'd always see him on his breaks. The thing is, he smoked cigarettes. Dentist smoked cigarettes. So I'd see him on his freaking breaks taking smoke breaks. It's like, damn, because I remember as a kid waiting in the waiting room for my appointment, looking at all the walls, you know, don't smoke. Horrible for your dental hygiene, terrible for your teeth, bad for your lungs, don't do it, right? Oh, every fucking wall. It's like, damn, dentist who smokes, but he smokes. And I just remember thinking, and I was like, shit, dentist who smokes? Isn't that just as bad as a coal miner who's afraid of getting dirt under his nails? I mean, like, a dentist who smokes? Not like a vegan that applies for a job at a butcher? I mean, come on, like a dentist who smokes? It's just as bad as a pastor who has an affair with a homosexual pot-smoking Democrat. I'll tell you what, can't get any worse than that, man. Stereotypes, man. The other day, I had a deaf lady, right? Deaf lady come to my job and my work. I was at the counter, right? And my roommate, she had like a sign language t-shirt on. And my coworker was like, thought he was all special and shit, because, you know, he remembered half the alphabet from middle school. And so they're like going through it together. I'm like, A, B, C, D, taking up, you know, time, supposed to be clean. It's like, oh, man. And they went through the whole alphabet super slow. Like, X, Y, Z, finally finished. And I'm like, okay, I step in front of the lane. I said, all right. But can you do that backwards while slightly intoxicated, pulled over on the side of the road at 3 a.m. in the morning from your beat up Chevy? I don't think so. I said, I don't believe you, you little cunt.
It's okay.
It's okay, she was deaf. She didn't know what the fuck I was saying. Doesn't matter. Y'all like to drink tea? I like to drink tea, iced tea, warm tea, herbal tea all day long. I drink a lot of tea. Whenever I make tea, I use the same tea bags over and over and over and over again, man. Get the most bang for your buck, right? The cool thing about tea, is you can do that. Because worst case, absolute worst case scenario, you just drink a lot of water. Drink a lot of water. What's the deal? The big butts. Dude, they're big butts, man. What's the deal, man? I know traditionally, historically, physically, we were attracted to curvaceous women because that meant we'd have a better chance of healthy, safe childbirth. However, in today's McDonald's, Walmart, American society, things have gotten out of control. And I mean, I know what you're thinking, but fat bottom girls make the rocking world go round. I know, but their gravitational pull is spinning us too damn fast. So every fucking day I'm at work, right? These customers are come up, they're trying to decide what they want. They look at me, and I come up, I'm like, hey, how can I help you today? You know, because that's what I'm supposed to do. And so often, man, so dang often, they get super defensive. Like, hey, I'm just looking. Okay, you just let me know whenever you're ready. All right, I'll come over here and scrub it though. Goddamn roof or whatever they have to clean in that day. I'm like, hey, but you know, that's the only situation in life. It's the only situation that's acceptable, man. Like, really? I can't be at the mall staring at a fat ass, controlling over there. And then the girl turns around and she's like, hey! Excuse me? Can I help you? I'm like, I'm just looking.
I'll be back.
All right, thank you.
Oh, man. Go for the Cougars.
Bo Aitha, everybody.